Okay, let's continue. So now I would like to start a systematic solution of differential equations. So it is not only a guesswork, but some systematic work. So we'll start from the simplest ordinary differential equation. Now, what is the simplest differential equation? It's the equation dy dx equals zero. So it is the problem, find a function such that its derivative is zero. Now, obviously, solution is y of x is some constant. C, arbitrary constant. And so the graph of solution is horizontal line. You can draw it at any C, and in particular, if you have a point x0, y0, and want to find a solution such that at the point x0 the value is y0, then C equals y0. That's it. Now, a more general equation of this form is the following equation: dy dx equals function of x. It's f of x is a given function. So how to solve this equation? So we have to find a function such that its derivative is a given function f of x. So we have to find this function. This such function is called indefinite integral, or antiderivative, or primitive function. So this means y of x equals integral fx dx. Now we can always add some c. Adding of a constant does not change derivative. Yes, so this means that function of this form is a solution. Now let us denote integral f of x dx, indefinite integral, let us denote by f capital of x. So this means that df dx equals f of x. And so this f of x, f of x, f capital, the indefinite integral, can be found in the tables of integrals, or you can find them in simple case yourself. And this is we have to find this integral. For simple f, it is simple. For more tricky f, it is a trickier thing. And there exists even function, elementary function f, such that there is no elementary integral of them. The integral is a new function. Now consider example. Dy dx equal, say, x square plus e to minus x. So we have this differential equation. Solution is y equals integral x square plus e minus x dx. Indefinite integral plus c. Never forget this c. There are two things which we should not forget to write. First, when we have indefinite integral, we have to add constant c. Yes, so these represent not one function, but a full family of function with different c. And second, we don't forget to write this dx. There is a bad habit to omit this differential. It is a wrong thing. In fact, it is a mistake. I will tell a little more later why we should write this dx. No, okay, let us find this integral. So we write y equals integral of x square x cube divided by 3. Integral e minus x, no, it is minus e minus x. Minus e minus x plus c. So this, for different c, we have different functions, and they form a family of solutions of this equation. No, the graph of this, say, for c equal 0, it is something like this. It is x. It is y. No, it is not for c equals 0. For c equals 0, we have to add some constant, and the graph will be something like this. We can draw for negative c. This is for positive c. So we can draw infinitely many such curves. Infinitely many such curves. So the characteristic property is that if we have an integral curve, so the graph of some solution of this equation, then any other curve, integral curve, is obtained by shifting it up or down by arbitrary distance plus c, positive or negative. Okay, now let me write, consider the initial value problem for our equation. Initial value problem. Equation dy dx equals f of x. It is an equation, and y at the point x0 equals y0. All these equation 1 and equation 2 form initial value problem. We have to find some solution of the differential equation such that at the point x0 it takes the value y0. So the general solution of equation is that y of x equals integral fx dx plus c, where c is some constant. We can take any constant, but we have to find constant such that this condition 2 is satisfied. Yes? So how to do it? Let me denote it by f of x. Yes? Then, so y equals f capital of x plus c. So again, what is f capital of x? It is some primitive function. Yes? In fact, if you look in the table of integral for some non-trivial function, integral of some, not the simplest functions, then in different tables, you can find different functions f. And they differ by a constant. We say that we have different normalization of this function. Say if this integral, this f of x, f capital of x, is a function which goes to some constant, then and is defined from 0 to, say, plus infinity, then in some tables you find this function such that it is equal 0 at 0. In other tables you find the function such that it goes to 0 as x goes to infinity. Yes, it's two different functions, and the difference is some constant. Let's take some of this function, some primitive function, and in particular let us try to find c such that condition 2 is satisfied. So for this we write y of x0 equals f of x0 plus c. On one hand it's this. On the other hand, y of x0 equals y0. This is this second equation, initial condition. Now, if they are equal to one and the same y of x0, we have f of x0 plus c equals y0. And so c equals y0 minus f of x0. So this way we found c. And so y of x, the full solution, equals f of x plus y0 minus f of x0. Now let us change the order. Equals f of x minus f of x0 plus y0. Now, what is f of x minus f of x0? F of x minus f of x0. It is nothing but integral from x0 to x f of x dx. It is primitive function, and we take the difference of the values of primitive function at two points. It is now the definite integral from x0 to x. And so y of x equals integral from x0 to x fx dx plus y0. No, okay. Let us make sure that this is solution of our problem. We have to check that this function, which is written here, satisfies our equation first, and second, that it satisfies initial condition. Now, first, with initial condition, y of x0 equals integral from x0 to x0 fx dx plus y0. No, this integral obviously equals zero. So it is equal to y0. So our initial condition is satisfied. Now, what about the equation? So solution is y of x equals integral from x0 to x fx dx plus y0. So dy dx, what is this? We take this integral, this integral has constant lower bound and the variable upper bound equals d dx integral from x0 to x. Let me write more accurately. If you integrate from x0 to x, let us write the variable of integration, say t f of t dt plus y0. Yeah, this does not change anything, but better not to confuse the variable of integration and the upper limit of integration. No, this is a constant. It does not depend on x, so its derivative is zero. So we don't take it into account. D dx integral from x0 to x f of t dt. And there is a theorem which is called the Newton-Leibniz theorem, which says that it is equal simply f of x, the value of the function, the upper limit. So it says that this formula gives us the antiderivative of a function. It is a deep fact because integral is defined independently on the operation of differentiation. Namely, if you have a function f of x, it is x, it is y, and we take the point, say, x0 and x, then this integral is the area between the x-axis, the graph of the function, and two vertical lines, x equal x0 and x is x. Now it is for positive function f. Is if s f is negative, we take this area with a sign minus. So it is what can be called signed area, area with sign. So this is the geometrical meaning. Now we can how to define this area. Let us go a little deeper. So this is our function. Let us take this curvilinear trapeze at x0, x. Now let us divide it into narrow vertical strips. No, here these strips here are not rectangle, so we have to somehow replace it by rectangles like this. So we have sort of staircase. And consider the sum of these rectangles. So this area, this distance is say delta, delta x. Yes, the height is somewhere between say it is x. It is x plus delta x. The height is somewhere between x and x plus delta x. F of x and f of x plus delta x. Delta x is small, so the variation of the function is also small. So we can take any value here and have some approximation. Say, take value at the lower, so it is x number I, x I plus delta x I is x I plus 1. Yeah, so it and then we consider the integral sum equals the sum f of x I plus 1 minus xi, I from, so it is x0, it is xn, from 0 to n, some n. Now we consider this sum, s number n. Now we let n go to infinity, xi plus 1 minus xi maximum go to 0. So these strips become narrower and narrower and go to 0. This distance, so this is approximately dx. And so we in the limit, this limit is defined, is formally sum fx dx. Yeah. Now, in the times of Newton and Leibniz, this was sum was denoted by capital S. Yes, instead of sigma, and s, say, x from x0 to x. Yeah, let us t. T from x0 to x, f of t dt. And then these great founders of differential and integral calculus, they change it a little, this s. So instead of this s, they wrote this s. Yes, and this s is what we now call integral. And so this notation, integral f x dx, which is, or f t dt, is this is sum of product f t dt, and this product is each term here is the area of this elementary rectangle. Yes. So this means that this dt is necessary. So this is the sum of these areas of infinitely narrow strips. So we cut this domain into infinitesimally narrow strips, and then find the sum of their areas. Yes, and now this is integral from x0 to x ft dt is the area of this trapeze, and now consider integral from x0 to x plus dx f of t dt. What is this? It is the area of this trapeze, so x0 x, and we add a small rectangle x plus dx. So we added this very narrow rectangle. So the height of this is f of x. Now up to some small piece here, which is maybe neglected, equals integral from x0 to x ft dt plus the area of this rectangle, it is f of x dx. Yes? So, integral from x0 to x plus dx ft dt minus integral from x0 to x ft dt. What remains? It is integral from x0 to x. This integral f0 to x plus dx, this cancels, remains this, equals f of x dx. So if you take this difference and divide by dx, let us do it. Integral from x0 to x plus dx ft dt minus integral from x0 to x ft dt divided by dx equals simply f of x. But this exactly the derivative of integral from x0 to x ft dt equals f of x. So this is the proof or a demonstration. It is not a rigorous proof, it's just demonstration why the Newton-Leibniz theorem is true. It is true simply because of this calculation which I performed here. Now let us return to our example. Divide dx equals x square plus e minus x, and y at the point, say 0 equals 1. So this is initial value problem. And let us solve it. By our formula, y of x equals integral from x0 to x. X0 is 0. 0 to x of this function t square plus e minus t dt plus 1 equals integral from 0 to x t square. It is x cube divided by 3 integral e minus t plus minus e minus x, and the e this function at the 0 is minus 1 minus plus 1 plus 1 equals x cube divided by 3 minus e minus x plus 2. Now let us check dy dx equals x square plus e minus x, so minus and minus gives plus. Derivative of 2 is 0, so it is fine. And y of 0 equals this 0 minus 1, it is equal 1, plus 2 equals 1. It is also okay. So this we found solution. This way we solve any equation of this form, dy dx is a function of x, and it boils down to integration. No, integration is a tough part of this course. We'll have a lot of integration here. So, it is more or less all what can be said about this simplest equation. So in the next lecture we consider much more interesting sort of equations. For now, bye.